Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. In this video, we will learn how to generate a triangular wave. Now, similar to the square wave and the sine wave, this triangular wave is also very useful in certain applications. And because of its linearity, this triangular wave is useful in analog to digital conversion as well as in many PWM circuits. And this pulse width modulation circuits can be used for designing a switch mode power supply or for controlling the speed of the motor using the control circuit. So let's find out how we can generate this triangular wave. Now, if you are aware, in the earlier videos, we have discussed that if you have a square wave, then using the integrator, we can generate this triangular wave. So if you have a readily available square wave, let's say from the function generator, then using the integrator circuit, we can generate this triangular wave. But if this square wave is not readily available, then we can generate this triangular wave by using these two modules. So the first module will be the square wave generator, and once we have a square wave, then using the integrator circuit, we can design this triangular wave. So for generating this triangular wave, there are two methods. So in the first method, we can use any Astable multivibrator for generating this square waves. And the output of this Astable multivibrator should be given to the integrator circuit. And using these two modules or using these two circuits, we can generate this triangular wave. Then if we see the second method, then in this method, using the Smith trigger and the integrator circuit, it is possible to generate this triangular wave. So here, the output of the integrator is given as one of the input to this Smith trigger. So in this particular video, we will see that how we can design this triangular wave using the Astable multivibrator and the integrator. And in the next video, we will see the second method. So first, let us talk about the first method. So like we had discussed in the earlier videos, using either op-amp or the 555 timer, it is possible to generate this Astable multivibrator. So in case of a Astable multivibrator, both states are unstable state and output continuously is to change between the two states. So this Astable multivibrator will act as a square wave generator. And here is the circuit using which we can generate this Astable multivibrator. So for the Astable multivibrator, which generates a square wave of a 50% duty cycle, the time period T can be given by this expression, where this beta is nothing but the feedback fraction. And for the given circuit, this beta will be equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So if we assume the value of R1 and R2 are equal, in that case, this expression will get simplified to 2 times RC times the natural log of 3. So using this expression, we can design a Astable multivibrator of the desired frequency. So now let's talk about the integrator. So once we discuss this integrator, then combining these two blocks or combining these two circuits, we can generate the triangular wave. So here, this integrator circuit is designed using the op-amp. And in the earlier videos, we have already seen that how this integrator can be designed using the op-amp. So for more information, you can check that video. So here, the input is given at the inverting node of the op-amp, and this capacitor C is connected in the feedback path. So because of this R1 and C, the input signal will get integrated. And here, for the stability, the feedback resistance RF is connected in the feedback path. So now, if we combine this Astable multivibrator with this integrator circuit, then it is possible to generate the triangular wave. So here, the output of this Astable multivibrator is given as an input to this integrator circuit. And if we observe the waveform at these two nodes, then it will look like this. So here, the yellow waveform is the output of the Astable multivibrator. And as you can see, the output varies between the positive and the negative saturation voltages. So once we give this square wave as an input to the integrator, then it is possible to generate this triangular wave. Now, so far, I had just told you that by using these two circuits, it is possible to generate the triangular wave. But We also need to select the component values very carefully, because if the values are not carefully selected, then we will not get the desired output. So now let us also calculate the component values and let us design a triangular wave of the given frequency. So let's say we want to design a triangular wave which has a frequency of 1 kHz. Now if you observe this waveform here, the frequency of square wave and the triangular wave are same. So first of all, we need to design a Astable multivibrator of 1 kHz frequency. So for the Astable multivibrator, we know that the time period T can be given by the expression 2 times RC times the natural log of 1 plus beta divided by 1 minus beta, where beta is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So for simplicity, let's say R1 is equal to R2 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. So in that case, this expression will get simplified to 2 times RC times the natural log of 3. Now here, for f is equal to 1 kHz, this time period T will be equal to 1 millisecond. And here, let us assume the value of C as 0.1 microfaraday. So if you put the value of this C in this expression, and if we simplify this expression for R, then the value of R will come around as 4.5 kilo ohm. So using these values, it is possible to generate a Astable multivibrator of 1 kHz frequency. So now let us calculate the component values for this integrator circuit. So for the given design, here the frequency f is equal to 1 kHz, or you can say that the time period t is equal to 1 millisecond. So for a better linearity of the triangular wave, the RC time constant of this integrator should match with this time period. So here the RC time constant is equal to R3 times C2, and it should match with the time period of this square wave, which is equal to 1 millisecond. And for the better linearity, the value of R4 should be at least 10 times more than this R3. Because if you have followed the earlier video of the integrator, then the cutoff frequency fc for the integrator can be given by the expression 1 divided by 2 pi times this feedback resistor RF times C. And in this case, it is equal to 1 by 2 pi times this R4 times C. So the cutoff frequency fc should be less than the operating frequency. And for the better linearity of the triangular wave, this cutoff frequency fc should be at least 10 times less than this signal frequency. So to match this condition, the value of this resistor R4 should be at least 10 times more than the R3. So that is being said, now let us select the value of this R4, R3 and capacitor C2. So like I said, the time constant R3 times C2 should be equal to 1 millisecond. So let's say C2 is equal to 0.01 microfaraday. So to get a time period of 1 millisecond, the value of R3 should be equal to 100 kilo ohm. And if we select the value of R3 as 100 kilo ohm, then to match this condition, R4 is equal to 10 times R3, the value of R4 should be equal to 1 mega ohm. So if we use these values, then we should get a triangular wave of 1 kHz frequency. Now, so far in our design, we have only talked about the frequency of this triangular wave, and considering the frequency of this triangular wave, we have designed the given circuit. But during the design, we should also be able to predict the amplitude of this triangular wave. So now let us find out how we can find the amplitude of this given triangular wave. So if you are aware, if Vin is the input to the integrator, then the output of the integrator can be given by this expression. So in our case, the input to the integrator is equal to the square wave. And as you can see, the output of the square wave can either have two values. That means either positive saturation voltage or the negative saturation voltage. So over here, suppose if we integrate this negative saturation voltage from this point to this point, then we should be able to get the peak to peak value of this triangular wave. So if we consider this total time as the time period T, then this time is nothing but the T by 2. So if we integrate this voltage for the T by 2 time period, then we will able to get the peak to peak voltage. So in this case, this peak to peak voltage will be equal to minus 1 by R3 times C2 times this negative saturation voltage multiplied by T by 2. So if we simplify this expression, then the peak to peak voltage of the triangular wave can be given by this expression. So as you can see, this peak to peak voltage of this triangular wave is directly proportional to the time period of this square wave, or you can say that it is inversely proportional to the frequency of the square wave. So for the given value of R3 and C2, if we increase the frequency of the square wave, then the amplitude of this triangular wave will reduce. So now let us simulate this circuit with the calculated component values and let us validate our design. So for the simulation, here I am using the Multisim Live, which is the online version of the Multisim software. So here I have already connected the circuit which we have discussed earlier, and the component values which I have selected over here are the same as the design values. And here at the output of these two circuits, I have connected the two voltage probes. So let us just run the simulation and let us see the output waveform. So if we run the simulation, then we will get this kind of waveforms. So for a moment, let me just stop the simulation. So here this green waveform is the output of the Astable multivibrator, while the blue waveform is the output of the integrator circuit. So first of all, let us see the frequency of these two waveforms. So if you observe over here at this node, the time scale is equal to 77.4 milliseconds, and at this node it is equal to 78.43 milliseconds. That means this time period T is approximately equal to 1 millisecond, or you can say that the frequency of the oscillation is equal to 1 kilohertz. That means the frequency of this triangular wave is also equal to 1 kilohertz. And if you observe over here, the linearity of this triangular wave is also very good. So now let us find out the peak to peak amplitude of this triangular wave. So before doing that, first of all, let us find out the saturation voltage of this square wave. And if you observe over here, it is approximately equal to 13.5 volt. Now, if you see the one end of this triangular wave, the voltage is equal to 6.57 volt. And at the other end, it is equal to minus 0.4 volt. That means the peak to peak voltage is approximately equal to 7 volt. And if you calculate the peak to peak voltage from the earlier formula, then roughly it will come around as 7 volt. So from the simulation, we can say that the circuit which we have designed is correct for the 1 kilohertz frequency. And using this component values, we will get the desired result. Now one more thing, if you observe over here, this triangular wave is DC shifted. So using the coupling capacitor at the output of the integrator, we can remove this DC offset. And here for the simulation, the op-amp which is used is LM324. So you can check the data sheet of this LM324 for more information about this op-amp. So basically, using the design component values, it is possible to generate a triangular wave of the 1 kHz frequency. So you can change the component values and you can see the effect of these component values on the output of this integrator. So I hope in this video, you understood the first method using which you can generate this triangular wave. And in the next video, we will talk about the second method. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.